Hello and welcome everyone to the FSR 2010 World Trophy Race 2012. Where have I been? I've been gone from FSR for about 3 years, so I kind of think it's 2012. However, welcome everyone, and welcome to this exciting race of FSR 2012. Okay, So, what do we have here? We have World Trophy with a spectacular field. We're doing 24s. The field was spread within, between 24s and 32s. 26 fastest drivers have qualified, and they will be racing this race over for the real points. Now, having those qualies done has taken a lot of time during the season. People have been testing all winter, all pre-season long. It's usually a bit more than in the usual other Grand Prix. Now, where do we start? We have 24 lovely drivers, which will be taking place on the grid. And I'm having a computer problem at the moment, so I'll probably be seeing... I'm seeing Melamed right now doing a 29 somewhere in sector 1. There we go. That's a good time. As we're going to follow the guy, since he is doing faster than normally than the other one, of course. Excuse me for my commentating for now. He goes through the fast again, 20 to 53, so 4 seconds off, or 10s off, and he goes into the third sector. Let's see what he can do about that. Make sure he can get Apex right there. There he goes, moving to P1 if he can. Fine, exit up through that corner. And see if I can see him, see if he can stay on black stuff. 1, 2, 3. And he takes third. That's a very good result for him. As we are watching Kaman as well, going through 14 and 15. See where he ends? He was 1/10 of the pace in that corner. Was he testing his tires? No. And he takes second. 3/10 of the pace of BRL. I'm wondering who that is, but I'll be in the game just in a second. And there we go with some live timing with on my screen. We have Pitar Brailjack on P1 with 26.165, which is a lovely little time. As we will have Mark Albers on second, as I'm getting you through the field right now. Since everything has to be going a little faster, since we've been missing out, I'm sorry for the interruptions, and I hope we can have a great race today. Now, let's see, who is... who? As we will be going to the race pretty soon, 20 seconds left. As the race director points out that there are 25 seconds left in the race, as I just told him, told you guys all. And we will see to have some exciting racing today. Let's make sure they stay on the black stuff. However, this is World Trophy and lots of stuff can happen through the race. Everyone is just getting told to be gentle and careful to turn one, lap one, and I'm gonna get my chips, and I'm gonna get my drink, and we're gonna start this race. Let's make sure we also... Oh, they also need to be mandatory, have mandatory launch controls, which is a button on the steering wheel they use for launching their cars off the grid, so they do not spin around and get into each other's side pass. So we have no Sebastian Vettel moves on the start. If you remember Spa 2010. Alright, let's see. No chat during the race, please. Only person I will be chatting will be probably me. As I'm... they won't see that, of course. And we go to the next session. Race. Taking part in 43 laps as we will start this race. 43 lovely little laps within this competition, as we will make sure we will be able to see that all. Let's see the grid. As on first place we have Andreas Nilsson. After a lovely qualifying session for him, we have Jan Moritz, come on, for GT Omega. Peter Brzojak on P3. We have Mark Albers on P4, as we are just restarting the warm-up as the broadcast went out. I'm getting pings and pings and pings. Excuse us for a second, we are having a game crash for the broadcast. That is... somebody's bad, but I was still looking at my main screen. Since that's usual what I do, so... whatever we lose, we are still here. I am still here to commentate on the rest of the race. That is, of course, if one can still hear me. As then we'll provide the drivers a bit more time to practice with their race setups, to practice with their full fuel loads, and then we will be able to see that those guys might be taking some practice starts and some more practice starts and some more practice corners, of course, as there is the SimRace TV. It has a mismatch, so it must have somewhere a RFM mismatch. Let's see. as we hope to get the server down. As they hope to get the server down. Well, anyway, I will be commentating anyway, so I won't be shutting up, even if that server, that broadcasting crashes, as they will go on with the race. Alright, and as we are going, server allowed mismatches now, so everything should be fine. Alrighty. As for the grid, once again, on one, P1, there is Andreas Nelson with for Twister Racing. On P2, there will be Jan Moritz Kamman for the GT Omega Racing team. Peter Brojak will take third for Twister Racing. Mark Albert will take fourth for Coast Speed Racing Team. Benjamin Burmeister will take fifth for GT Omega. Well, Giovanni Almon will take sixth for Coast Speed Racing Team. Seventh place for Nick Fisher, ATR Development. 8th place for Mo Salveria for Silver Line Racing. Those are my old buddies. Kainer Basel with Go Speed Pro Engineering. Maximilian Malamed for ATR Development. Kevin Clark for Faster Than Speed. Marshall Thomas for AT Racing Development. Maurice Brackham for Eternal Grand Prix. Then we will have Danny van der Neet on Netrex Junior. Sebastiano Filosa for AT Racing Development. Tim Brook for Silver Line Racing. Johannes Hunkel for Precision Motorsport. Matteo Zandona for Faster Than Speed. Rob Swindles for Netrex Junior. As we then have Thomas Fadler for Eternal Grand Prix, Mikko Tsivokas for Silver Line Academy, the secondary team of Silver Line Racing, Gio Nicola for First Faster Speed, Panthers secondary team as well, Sammy Pisari for RFRWT, and for 24th, and then we will have Edward Kaur on the Night Racing Car on 25th, while we have as last driver on the grid Andrea Denise. Now people are getting ready to start, and we are going to back to the front to Andreas Nelson, as we will start of the 2012 FSR Grand Prix World Trophy, as we will get the lights. As you may know, in regular Formula 1, as it will be in sim racing as well. Lights are on, 5 lights, and FSR 2012 is go! As Nelson takes first, good start at the front, and we have Noah Comment goes into the midland, goes off the track, as the rest of the back of the field is probably is well in trouble. As we are checking that. Oh, everyone go through. Everyone go through perfectly. Nelson takes first, Brojak takes second. With a lovely start from the Twister Racing guys, first and second. As we will have Go Speed Racing Team chasing the Twister teams down. As Brojak and Mark Albers are right on with the battle for second place. Let's see how that goes on, as they will probably have a fight for quite a few laps, as Albers is obviously a little faster than Brojak during the qualifying sessions. But we'll need to see that how that works out in a race pitch, of course. As Nelson then takes a wide exit out of that turn, and Albers right down to that next turn, and Brojack defends his position and wins the thing, as we then will have Albers attacking again in the final corner in a bit, normally. As we... Oh! And Albers makes a mistake, and that won't be a attack on the next section, unless he takes a slipstream right. However, he is on a strange line, as Jack, of course, tries to block off his slipstream and prevent Albers to get the slipstream. Nilsson making a 32-4-9. As we will go see the positions, Andreas Nilsson takes first, Peter Bojack takes second, Mark Albers takes third, Joanny Aumann fourth, and Maximilian Malam at 5. That's the first 5 grid positions for this point. As we do not seem to have too many battles on track yet. Oh, we have Tim Brook. We have Tim Brook fighting for 9th place. Burmeister going in through the inside, and no, he doesn't do it. As Burmeister will then get attacked by Marshall Thomas. Marshall Thomas on the back of Burmeister, and no, he will not get attacked. Oh, Burmeister making a mistake. Tim Brook. Going for Tim Brook. No. Is he going to take the inside? No, he's not. As he will then try again at the next turn. Will he? No. Turn one, maybe. And in the back, Rob Swindles getting attacked. Oh, Rob Swindles is attacking Marshall Thomas. As he got past it swiftly. As we go back to Burmeister, who will take action at T1, and he won't. Because he wants to save his wings, as he was going to T3, and T3 won't work out for him. We see an attacking maneuver in the back there too, as we see Burmeister attacking Brook again. No, he does not. I think he's a little scared of using his wings, which is normal on the first race. You don't want to crash out in the first race. As back in front, the gaps are still good for your information. As we will stay with this fight for a moment. Our cameraman is getting nifty hand right now because he's kinda one needing to know where he's going. However, Burmeister and Tembrook still fighting as he goes into that fast chicane. Oh, the inside! That was a brilliant move right there. That was one brilliant. Tim Brook going back around the outside. Will he? Yes. Oh! Tim Brook is off. That's a sad little attack from Tim Brook. Of course, we kind of did see that coming after a little fighting for 2 laps. That's, yeah. Sad for him. Well, that gets the action going. At front, we still have Andreas Nilsson, Peter Brojack takes second. As we have Alberts at the back of him. As Joanny Aumann takes fourth. Maximilian Malamed takes fifth. Nick Fischer takes sixth. Danny van der Neet on 7. Kenner Basel 8. And Benjamin Burmeister 9th. With Rob Swindles in 10th. After losing Tim Brook right there. As we will go back to the front. Let's see if there is... See if we can provide you any battles at the front. Mark Albert still chasing down Brojack. We'll need to see how that will get on in a bit. As we will have, we have plenty of times in the midfield that are close together. Let's see if we can have some drivers there to see how they're fighting right there. Yes, we have starting from 13th actually. We have this gaggle of cars starting from 13th, 14th, 15th, and 16th all over each other. As we will see how that works out, as Kevin Clark and Matteo Zanana, both team members of Faster Than Speed, are trying to fight it out with each other as Matteo just rigs out and does not finish the attack. It's quite nifty at turn one, as also there is the Silver Line car involved, and Zedona taking time, take the inside, almost driving his teammate off. That's a little silly. As then Clark still gets attacked. No, not getting attacked. Zandona is getting attacked by that Silver Line Academy car, Mako Zuokas. As you try. Oh, and Clark hits its front wing at the wall. That's a bit sad for that one, too. So pretty much people feeling pressure in it. You know, of course, it's Melbourne first race, and we will see quite a bit of accidents as people are trying to get through to the race pace again. Suoka is in 15th place, still not getting attacked by Pissari. Some of Pissari actually being a quite experienced driver, since he's driving for a few years already. Pissari tries to attack, and he does not attack, as Mao is going to the front. The front is being okay, as we then move back to 14th place, since that fight is still going on. We see Suokas, and oh, that Faster Than Speed guy, Sam Pissari, making a little mistake. Back at the front, it's still Andreas Nilsson, Peter Brojek, and Mark Albers. Which is quite steady at this moment. If Albers, however. Oh, there is a guy off, and that is P22. Has somebody. That's a Faster Than Speed guy who is off the racing line and on the grass. As you can see, however, I am not following that guy. Which is. Oh, that's that guy without wings. Excuse me. Then we will go with back to Peter Brojek in second. As he will get attacked from Mark Albers, actually. And he is. Mark Albers right on the back of Peter Brojek. Trying to get that last corner right. If Albers can get that last corner right, he will be able to attack that Brojek guy. They will try to attack at T1. Nope, he will not attack at T1, and he loses a bit of play time to that first corner, which is sad, so he could not attack at turn 3. Please, guys, give us the excitement of a good overtake. Make it clean and make sure you will both get the finish line done. Of course, two little experienced teams right here in first and second. Well, first, second, and third and fourth, of course. Kind of like some years ago in the Turkish Cup, Red Bull and McLaren trying to fighting it out in Turkey. Well, so it's about the same thing. We have Albers is trying to close the gap in the middle sectors, and then in the first corner he doesn't attack, so he probably has not enough. Oh, and Albers almost off. That was quite nifty, as he's just about to slide off, but he didn't, which is good for him, of course. Would give us some excitement, but we don't want these guys off too fast, because that will remove the excitement for the rest of the race, since they have to overtake each other. Let's go further down the field. See what they have there. As we see, we are going to get Filosa. We are mounting Filosa right now, as we are going to T1 again. And Albert's losing a lot of time on Brojek right now, as he is. Is Albert having trouble with his tires, I wonder? I'm gonna see at Albers a little bit, as we are going to go through that first few sectors again. He's kind of losing a lot of time right now. As we go through that section of the... is he losing too much time? Is the gap between him and Peter Rojek has gone up to a second. As, it seems to be a little off for the Ghost Speed Racing guys. Of course, he might be saving his tires a little bit more, like just like in real life one. They have to save their tires to get through a decent strategy. Of course, the race is a little... Oh, and we have Swindles and Fisher! Fisher is off! Fisher went off after trying to overtake Swindles. That's not a good thing, as, of course, that was a little bit... Oops. As they will then move back. Give us a fight less, of course. Damn it, guys. Might want to give, and as Miku Tsuoka has retired from the race, as also has Kevin Clark and Miku Tsuoka. Miku Tsuoka, Andrea Denise, and Kevin Clark. Nope, Kevin Clark still racing. Excuse me. As we now will have. Andreas Nilsson and Peter Brojek being 1 second off from each other, and Peter Brojek is already getting back attacked from Mark Alberts. Mark Alberts closed the gap very fast. Watch those guys again, as we will be looking for another attack through the final corners, as we will go through T1. Again, see if you can take the slipstream now. You probably must have learned a little bit against this time, as he will try to fight. He will try to, at least, try. Nope, he will not try in the first sectors. I will see the track lineup. As we see, I mean, finally, no track corners, since I have racked my open. As we then will see, give you some education on track corners in a little bit. As we then will see that, see where everyone is. Let's take a grid positions. We have Andreas Nilsson on 1, and we have Peter Brojek on 2. Followed by Mark Alberts, pretty fast, which then was overtaking another guy who was lapped. Giovanni Allman in 4th. Maximilian Melamed in 5th. Danny van der Neet in 6th. Benjamin Burmeister in 7th. As we then have Kinner Basel in 8th. Rob Swindles in 9th. Maurice Brackhorn in 10. And Marshall Thomas just fending off Filosa, as we will stay with that for a bit. We'll stay with that, fighting for 11th place on the grid in the race, as we will see how that goes in the Jones and Brabham corners, which are T1 and T2. As we will then see what's going on right there. First corner, will he take it? Will he try it? As of course Thomas outbreaks himself, and then he gives Filosa the place. Of course, he must have been a little bit scared of the Basil, or a little bit scared of Filosa to. Yeah, of course, going in, that's a little bit off. You do that in bed and not in cars. As, then we will, of course, go further around the field. So, Filosa, 11, and Thomas, 12. As, at the front, there's nothing changed. I'm sorry for my cameraman, but you didn't. Dona takes 13th. Sam Pisari is 14th. Johannes Kunkel Johannes Kunkel being in a fight with Edward Carr, almost, as Tim Brook is also now on the banquet of Edward Carr. Fighting it out for 15. Which is Pat Carr and Tim Brook being right into the back of each other. Tim Brook will try on Carr. Tim Brook will try on Carr. Let's go. Carr now is there. He has shown it there. He opened the window a little bit as he tried to check off the slipstream. As it doesn't work out, and Tim Brook loses a lot of time in T1. That's a shame, because that was a really good move if it sticked. As we will then move back down to the front, have a little bit over the... we might have the pit stops coming soon enough. And of course, some people like to get out fast in the beginning of the race. And some people like to get out slow in the beginning of the race, so they can go fast at the end of the race. Of course, that slow in the beginning will take a little bit more fuel, and they will go longer, but we should normally have a pit stop window in a few moments, a few laps. As we will then have two laps, guys, and we have three retirements at this moment. Project will try on Nilsson. Project and Nilsson are catching up to each other. I wonder if there is a little bit of team order right there. See if we can stay on that for a little bit, as Nilsson is definitely losing time on his teammate. But he might not want to keep his teammate up, since, you know, that's a little bit odd sometimes. She might be getting the message, like, and Project is faster than you, as we had in certain Grand Prix of the real life Formula 1 a few years ago. As you might want to see how that's going, as the Project guy tries to... He's a little bit off on the second sector, so he might have lost a little time there. Also, must mind the clipstream of those guys. It'll also take off some... and we lost a wing there. I saw a wing fly there. I wasn't knowing where it's coming from. As the first three guys certainly have a wing still. We have... that's Kevin Clark's. That's Kevin Clark's wing, who they were driving over. And Kevin Clark has going over, given up. As we have the first pit stop in fifth for Maximilian Melamed in fifth place. Sixth now, seventh. As also Burmeister is in, as I saw, I told you guys, the first pit stops are coming in. So, there we go. As Burmeister gets out in 9th place, as does... and we have a guy coming out of the pit, and Thomas trying to get rid of... And there's an engine smoking there. That Burmeister... fuck up his engine mode through the... Oh, and Burmeister going in the... Oh! Pressing Zandona out of the car, pressing both faster than speed cars out of the race. That is a little bit... not good, as that would be... That is gonna be... A faster than speed guys must be very pissed right now, as they will try to... probably fill in a complaint. As Zandona is okay. Zandona is okay after that incident. However, there's other faster than speed guy out there that is a little bit less happy, as we're trying to find out who that was, since that's Sami Saari. That's just unlucky thing for him, as he probably would have wished more from his race. That's kinda as Mark Alberts. It's Mark Alberts and Alman have taken a pit stop. The first Ghost Speed guys have taken a pit stop before the Twister Racing guys. So now see how Twister Racing can go on. Of course, it's like real life racing. If you have better tires, you might improve your lap time. Also, however, if you have more fuel, less fuel, you might also have been high on that one, having less tires. This depends on tire management. Let's see how Nilsson and Clark will do that strategy for that pit stops. See where they come out. As I have a car number 4 thing stuck on the racing line. No, that's, I was stuck on my radar. Excuse us for that. As Nilsson still not coming in. Are they? Nilsson is coming in. Nilsson is coming in. As Project is staying out. Project taking a few laps. Taking a few more laps. Of course, in the end of the race, the better you have your tires, the better you can finish. So also, you need to a little bit preserved on the cars, as we have Johannes Kunkel being chased down by Van der Nee. And I have to see how's that that's going. As Kunkel goes, Kunkel tries to defend. He also knows a few years of FSR. He kind of knows the tricks. He kind of has the whole trick box inside of his car. He will try to get attacked. He will try to defend an attack in turn one. He is setting himself up defensive on Van der Nee and getting wide on turn one. As Van der Nee gets a free one right there, that's a little odd. As Tim Brook will also get that place. If he, oh, and Kunkel closes that door and almost gets off to the racing turf. As Tim Brook then is surprised, of course, and loses a little time, and Nick Fisher right there. This is all going on for 10th place. As Tim Brook is a little bit confused, he's moving left and right, Shaka's car, I think, as Tim Brook loses a lot of time through that corner. Will he get attacked? No, not yet. However, this is, oh, it's Fischerhoff and Kunkel off, taking Rob Swin, take Kunkel and, oh, that was a little bit, oops, that was not well for there. That's Kunkel spinning and then the other guy with him too. That is a bit sad, but it happens, of course, it's a racing incident. However, that's not something you might as want as a following driver. So, Kunkel obviously has the experience, but lots of experience can make mistakes too, much to Michael Schumacher at the last race of 2010. Also make mistakes and get along from that. So, what do we have after pit stops? Twister Racing has stopped as well. As then we will have Peter Brojack in 1, Mark Alberts in 2nd, Andreas Nilsson in 3rd, Johan Allman in 4th. As we have lost sight on the lead for a bit, and they have changed. So we will see how that works out between Goy Speed and Twister Racing. I wonder what's going on with their team radios right now. However, I can't get team radios at this moment. Jonas, that was a little bit odd from Jonas Kunkel. That's still a bit. Still wondering who that second guy was, as I was not looking at the names out there. As Peter Brojack and still going on quite well in T1 and in P1. So it must be pretty good settled. See how those times do. They'll reach a new sector just in a little bit. As going to see, 21 runners still out on the field after a little bit of excursions. Of course, it's the first race and people do make mistakes, so obviously in the first few races that'll be something normal to be seen. As of course most experienced teams being on this grid, of course take the experience through lots of world championship teams supporting World Trophy drivers, as they will then be trying to get their driver on the top spots and in the lower class league, and then of course they have a little experience, they have teams we can, they have all those sniffy things that can get them through the race in one piece, and with masterminds on the guys and the backs. Of course it's all professional right now, it's all very professional in this league, as you see. People doing their best to win a race even, and World Trophy is of course, it is an important thing, it's not top notch for nothing. So, as we will see, Project and Mark Albers, we don't really have any caps at this moment, as everyone with fights have driven themselves out of the race, sadly enough. So we will have to watch people driving our own tracks instead of people fighting, as that is a little bit more less to talk about, but however, we will try to get all done that should be talked about. Then can just see how that's all going out. There's not really much gaps closing at this moment. I can see Mark Albers still trying to follow the project, still not working on it. Everyone is quite moved on and quite well, for the race, so yep. And at this point it is a little bit boring, as everyone gets to got through their first pit stops, and everyone is a bit clearer in the race, everyone is getting a bit more focused on the finish of the race, of course, as we'll see what is going on very shortly. Running without wars, of course, and so I myself as mayor did the league for 3 years, and I run back into commentating, actually emergency commentating, so excuse me if I do forget things that are supposed to be officially. I do think we have to also see that our sponsors are applied to, which are iSeed, as I can see next to the track, iSeed, Trustmaster of course being the biggest sponsor of them all, I think, as the race will be organized by race department as well, and that's about it, I think. Simrace TV, races hosted on simrace.tv, where you can all see us lovely drivers see drive their races and get commentary, of course. Of course, without commentary there wouldn't be a... It'd be a little bit boring without commentating, I guess. However, of course, if you know something about it, you can... Oh, and we have two drivers. We found two drivers right on the back of each other. Finally, we have Sainer Bajal at P7 and Danny van der Neet on P8. As we will try to see how those guys work out, and see if there can be some loving between them, and see if they can stay keep it on the track for a change. As I do not want every fight resulting in a crash, of course. That's a little bit boring for us, and that's a bit boring for the spectators as well. Of course, they can't do anything about it, because mistakes are human. So, before I get whacked by any team manager, they can't do anything about it. I just say that it's human to make a mistake, and of course that's a little bit normal to have in the first races. People are a little bit more tense in the first race usually, and in any special race, of course, except Monaco, everyone is a little tense, and you know, you hit walls and stuff like that, and because you're tense, and you know, it happens in sim racing. Because this is one of the biggest leagues of them all, and you do get a little bit pressure, so I kinda understand how it goes. And I hope you do too now as well, as we will see what Basel and Van der Neet are doing, as in front we still have everything rigged out quite nicely, as I'll notify you if we have something at the front, as Basel and Van der Neet are going to go for the fast chicane, as Van der Neet is right under the back of them. Will they go through the fast chicane side by side? Yes, they will, and Van der Neet attacking. No, he does not finish it. Next corner, Van der Neet inside. Van der Neet inside, going to try to take the lead. Going to try to take 7th. And he does take 7th. Nope, still side by side. Still side by side. Oh, the penultimate corner right to the bed. Still side by side. Awesome little racing there. Basel keeping the spot, and Van der Neet still being behind it. Final corner. Van der Neet still feeling the pressure, still feeling the little breathing on the neck, still breathing on down on the neck of Basel. As will he try the inside? No, he will not try in T1. He will not try in T3. No, they will not try, since Van der Neet is a little bit far off right now. As we have Matteo Zandona finishing his race with the brake failure. As that's a oops, because he might just have had a little bit more brake and he would be fine, but that's up to him, of course. He can't know that. It's the first race, everyone makes logistic errors. As Van der Neet attacks Basel and almost got tapped each other off, going through the fast chicane, as we will try and get Van der Neet going through the inside again. Oh, well, almost touching again either. Again, as Van der Neet moves wide through that chicane. It's the weight chicane, if I ever. And they're moving through the Ascari chicane now. As we will then move to the Stewart chicane. I told you I was going to take you some track corner names. And this is Senna and Prost as they last curve. As that is the track layout, as we will also have Jones and Brabham in T1 and 2, that's T1 and T2. Of course, that's a little bit confusing to know the corner names, I think, but it does help out a lot. It's just except T1, T2, T3. I use usually corner names as I try to race. Of course, as we go through that first section, that's all well. Go see back up. Oh, what has happened to Ghost Speed? There is something happened. One and two are now Twister Racing. Has Ghost Speed taken a pit stop right there? We did take their pit stops a little bit earlier, so might want to see about that. I do not see a pit stop between those guys. What has happened between those? I wonder. I see Andreas Nilsson just took over the place from Mark Albrecht, and we haven't seen that. That's a little bit. Try and see that where that happened. See if we can hand you a little replay. That must be possible. Oh, Andreas Nilsson had a connection issue. That is the problem of his... No, Andreas, yes, he had a connection issue. No, he had not. He was already in front of that. Gonna have to watch earlier. Excuse me for a second, I'm trying to find for you where it is happened. One of the Ghost Speed guys have taken a mistake. Albert's made the mistake at T1. However, say then, of course, others can make mistakes. We all make mistakes in the first race, and always happens. Everyone does that. It's a little bit more pressure than everyone else, because the whole world will be watching, and of course, it's always a bit more spectacular at the first race. So we will then move on with the rest of the race once I'm back in live mode. There we go. As we will then have a... We will not have a fight. Which is sad, of course. We want fights. As... Marshall Thomas also has retired with brake failure. Let's take you through the grid. It's Beetle Project on first for Twister. Andreas Nilsson on second, after a mistake from Mark Alberts in third. Giovanni Allman in fourth. As Maximilian Malamed as takes fifth. With Benjamin Burmeister in sixth. Sinner Basel at seventh. As we have Rob Swindles in eighth. Maurice Bacon in ninth. As then will be Bracken in 9th. We have Filosa in 10th. Danny van der Neet in 11th. Edward Corr in 12th. Tim Brook 13th. Sami Pisari 14th. Joan Nicola 15, and he is the first one lapped, seems, as we then have Takito Nunes for our in 16th position, with Nick Fisher in 17th. Retirements for today is Marshall Thomas, Matteo Zandana, Jan-Moritz Kammann, Johannes Kunkel, Thomas Fadler, and Kevin Clark. As well as Andrea Denise and Mo Silveria, as we will also have Miko Tsoukas. So we then move up to the front again, and we have no fights, so just the racing still being up in front with 16 laps to go. I don't know if anyone made a two-stop strategy. Probably they will, because it seems a little bit longer than their usual race of the past. In the past time, the lowest class did, I think, 26 laps, if I can stand corrected. So they will have made to make two stops, I think. As of course, we try to cover you as much as we can. Nilsson and Alberts are over the back of each other again. Alberts trying to catch up with Nilsson. As they go through the fast chicane. And they will be trying to attack each other. Hopefully they can stay on track. As Alberts tries to close the gap a little more. We will see how that goes in T1. Of course, Prost and Senna. Oh, and Alberts makes a pit stop. That might be a little bit smart, since he will be trying to make a little bit faster lap times. So that aided him a few bits ago too. As Melamed and Burmeister join him in the pit lane, as Albers get the free pass out, there we go, and he rejoins in 4th position. There we go. Roljak and Nilsson just cruising still, 1 and 2. As Albers made this pit stop. I wonder what Alman is going to do as well then. As he might as well take his pits up, as their strategies probably will be the same-ish. As then we will see what it goes through with Project. Let's follow Project for now. He has been taking the lead for a while and he hasn't been commentated very well. And I don't want him to feel bad when he watches the replay. So let's just see how that goes. Project doesn't take a pit stop. We then have Nilsson, who doesn't take a pit stop either. Alman taking his pit stop. We have Alman taking his pit stop in 3rd place. As we'll see how that goes. What place will he be coming out again? As we can see his pit stop. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nope. I cannot see any seconds anymore. Takes six seconds these days to take a pit stop. That's awfully fast, as he comes out before Albers, which means he did a faster lap on the in lap, as Albers and Alman trying to fight each other out. Alman's driving each other on the track. What the hell is going on? These guys are teammates, for God's sake. That's gotta hurt if Pedro Rodriguez sees that. Good God. Pedro Rodriguez obviously being the manager of GoSpeed, correct me if I'm wrong, but I do remember it was that way. As Alman tries to fend off Albers in a very aggressive way, almost punting his teammate off the track. That was a scary situation right there. As Peter Brojek will take a pit stop. I'm going to see about the GoSpeed guys. Well, you're always taking a pit stops, and we'll see what's going on with GoSpeed guys, as they probably will be getting shouting on the team radio. Of course, if they have that, they will get shouted at the team radio, I'm sure of it. But we'll have to see. Peter Brojek comfortably getting out in 2nd. Of course, the GoSpeed guys with that fight with each other, they have lost quite a bit of time, I imagine. So we'll have to see how that works out for those. As Nilsson's still out in front, as we will see what's going on with his pit stop, since he's kind of waiting a bit longer, so it seems. As we will see how that works out. As you'll see, Nilsson, of course, first position. Twister Racing also being a quite experienced team, running 1st and 2nd here. They have lots of experience, they have lots of data from earlier years, so they know how to win a Grand Prix. Of course, I don't know if the drivers are new, but I do think so. So I've never seen them before, and they might be just relying on their team radio and seeing what there can be done. As Nilsson comes in, of course, all very organized. Twister Racing doing right like in real life. They don't really try to take the pit stops at the same time, because that might get them queued as well, so they don't want that. Of course, as Nilsson gets out in 2nd position, where is Alman to take over? Alman is not here yet, as Alman, seriously, the GoSpeed guys have lost a lot of time during those pit stops, as that was expected, because the guys were fighting right after the pit stop, and they might have lost quite a bit of ground there. However, Albers seems to be able to lower the gap down, just depending on what tires they are on now. If they are able to change tires. So, we'll have to see. Of course, this is sponsored by Race Department. This is organized Race Department, sponsored by Thrustmaster and RCT. So, that should all be done good with the sponsorship management there. As Thrustmaster and RCT, they're very good partners, so it seems, of FSR. Which is RCT.net, I see here. Whispered into my eyes. I don't know how you can whisper in somebody's eyes, but it seems to me it can be done with me. However, we have Rob Swindles getting attacked from Velosa for P10. We will go into that because that is a fight and that's what you want. As we go, Velosa take attacking. Oh, almost went wrong as well as they go to the fast little curve. I will see how that is working out. The chicane, 1, 2. Filosa not making an error. That's good. But you can't give up Swindles, as Swindles seems to have a faster line out of that chicane. But we'll stick with these guys for a bit, since there's not much other things going on. However, as they will go to Rob Swindles, go to 3-1. I don't know why Filosa is taking a second little lane outside of the slipstream of Swindles. Is he saving his tires, I wonder, or is he saving his engine? Of course, both could be possible. Also, he could be saving his brakes. So if you see people doing that, he might be saving something. Or just being stupid. That's also an idea, but from the assumption, people in this race are not stupid, just not to, get hammered after the race. Of course, we'll have to see what's going on in front. Everything is stable in front. Peter Brojack, Andreas Nilsson, Almand, Alberts, Malamed 5th, Burmeister 6th, with Danny van der Neest behind him on 7th. Sainer Basel on 8th, then we have Maurice Bracken, and then we have Swindles and Filosa, which Filosa seems to have made an error, since Filosa is right. Oh, he's back on top of him. That's good. We want these guys on top of each other, of course. We want them fighting. That's right, Filosa for now, as we will then see how he is able to attack Swindles. And at this moment, the answer is not, since that is quite far off. However, he might do a ninja move, which he does not. So that's quite fair from him. Ninja or kamikaze, whichever you like. As we then go to 3-3 with you guys, T4. And we'll take the faster little thing, as they will... Filosa almost getting its wheels on the grass right there, which is... I don't know, he didn't lose time there, so that must be good. It's moves to... Oh! Almost hit the back of Swindles. Remember, we do not want an accident. They can't hear me, but we do not want an accident. As these are the only guys fighting at this moment. As we have to stop the front of the stable, so as we just continue with this fight, as Filosa will try to get up at the back of Swindles, who is... Filosa is losing a lot of time in these fast little sections, while then Swindles, of course, running out, and don't know why, he might just have a better setup for the corners, for the fast corners, as Sebastian Filosa might have a little bit less wing to be able to accelerate a little faster Also, Filosa is not really taking the slipstream. I wonder if there's something with his engine there. Oh, we see a smoking engine, even. Did we see a smoking engine? That's smoking tires, that's not what I was looking for. I was looking for a smoking engine. Which is no smoking engine anymore. Okay, if somebody... Tacticunnooms. He... DNF'd. So, with an accident, so that might be having... That might have been the smoke I've seen. As we then go back to Swindles and finish Velosa. To the tightest battle on the track. See what they can do. Velosa almost making a mistake there. Try not to get your car in the wall there, as we want to see the fight. As that is, of course, logical. As we will then try to see. Joan Nicola left with the brake field here, which is sad. Also, Marshall Thomas breaks. Lots of brake issues this first race, which is quite a surprise, but I think the driver is just as surprised as we are that they. That their brakes are not taking as long as they supposed to. Or not as long as people would hope they have taken. As, then, we'll have to see. Try to see some reactions already. Going to on the forums to see the retirement reactions, as that might be a good idea. That's my track map right here. That's I might not want to delete that. So I'm watching the race too, apparently, through my other TV, but I'm not paying attention to it, so I can't hear myself. Obviously, that's a little odd to hear yourself sometimes. Surely, we were speaking yourself. As then, nothing is going on again. Swindles and Bracken are 4/10 off. Noons accident. Then, oh, did I just see someone fighting? It's Swindles and Bracken trying to battle it out. Eternal and Netrex Jr. So we'll try to see how that goes on. As Prakan tries to hang on, or Swindles tries to hang on to Prakan and see how that goes. Swindles can't follow through that turn, that's a little bit odd. Swindles are getting followed by Filosa. Filosa's right in the back of him, and if Swindles doesn't make a move on Bracken, he might lose a position to Filosa. So he might be a little bit pressure right now, which is giving lovely little television for us, of course. That's always handy. Bracken breaks, Swindles breaks, and the other guy breaks too. As of course the other guy being Filosa. As we then will see the front, everything is stable in front, that's good. As we have 6 laps to go, ladies and gentlemen. 6 laps to go. We will be ready to pick up the leader when it's the last lap, of course. As those guys are the guys who train the most, of course. Let's go to the top 5. Your top 5 is Peter Brojack, Andreas Nilsson, Allman in 3rd. We have Alberts in 4th. We have Melamed in 5th, Burmeisters in 6th, Vanderneet in 7th, Basel in 8th, and Bracken in 9th. Also Rob Swindles in 10th. As they are battling it out for P10, of course, as I see Sweddos getting attacked by Filosa around the outside of that corner, and he is not getting it, but he might have lost a little time to the inside there. We'll have to see how that is, and I see number 3 off on my track map, which is not the case, of course, my track map being a little out of date. Lagging a little bit, that's called lag, and that's something else than... It's called... yeah, oops. As Swindles gets attacked by Filosa on the, curve, as we will go to Prost and Senna soon enough. Last two corners, of course, Prost and Senna. As we'll see how those last two corners work out. See what's going on. Filosa keeps on the back. Oh, wait, touches the glass. And that's a little sad because he can't attack that way because his grip is gone, basically. As we'll then see what he does in turn 3, Filosa, but he does not attack. That's a little sad. You want attacking, guys? Come on. I want to be cheering for you guys. As Pisari has retired from the race. Sorry, had a little excursion. What is he doing? First care through that corner. Is he saving fuel? Is he out of fuel? I wonder. We'll see you in a little bit. I see gravel dusting up there. It's a Swindles and Brackhorn and Filosa has gone off. Filosa going off too! Making a spin. Oh, and losing. Not losing his rear wing. That's a strong little car. That's. That was a right turn from 10 to 12. Might not want to get involved in that. That's a little sad for him, as we will go back to Mirage Brackhorn and Ralph Swindles. Swindles all over the back of Brackhorn. And attacking in T1, nope, not attacking, think better of it. As he then goes to T3. Chase Brackhorn down to T3. Will Brackhorn take a defensive move? No, he will not. As Swindles will not attack at this corner. However, he feels a little bit sad because he could have, since Brackhorn made a little mistake, and Swindles made a mistake because Brackhorn made a mistake. As we see that Tim Brook had an engine failure, that might have been the smoking engine I've been seeing earlier on. As Brackhorn and Swindles still fighting it out for P9, that is, P8 that is. P9 being the ladder position. As back in front, it's all stable. Brojack, Nilsson, Almond and Alberts. Still 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's all fine. As we will get Brackhorn and Swindles are fine. So we will go to the front. See how they're doing. Since of course they need a little bit of cheering as well. As you know, they are the ones that work hardest, of course. Of course everyone works hard in this league, and of course the ones in front are usually either working hardest, they're all working very hard in these teams. Very good teams, very, very stable teams also, and they try to work as hard as they can, everyone tries to do so. Of course, the ones that work the hardest are up front, usually, and that's sometimes the best way, of course. As long as you have worked hard, you can, of course, take the fruits from it. Swindles and Brackhorn still fighting it out. We will stay at the front as we can. And see what's going on at the front. As we'll see, Swindles and Brackhorn still fighting at the last lap probably. But that it's 3 laps to go and I'd like to go to the leader. However, I'm keeping an eye on... we go back to Swindles and Brackhorn. Swindles is all over the back of Brackhorn. Going through the corner, inside, no, he does want to save his wing since Rakan just cut him off, as that was a little bit risky for both of them. As Senna and Prost, we still see how that works out in turn 1. 2 laps to go, as we will then see how that will work out for P8. We're fighting for P8 here, turn 1. Going for turn 1, goes to take the inside. No, he doesn't take the inside, and moves a troll over the back of Rakan. Positioning for turn 3. Turn 3 takes the outside. He tries at the outside. Will he stick? Will it stick? It does stick. It does stick. The inside of turn 4. No, it doesn't stick. Lovely little fighting action right there. Please don't crash today. Please don't crash in this one. As we will have the last lap of the leading man. We'll see how that works out. We will see how this works out. I'm watching the first driver. I'm watching the first driver to see when he comes over the line. Don't worry about that. Don't worry. We will have that little fight still on. Oh, and Swindles makes a mistake. That's game over for Swindles right there. As we will go to P1 then. Of course, they have worked the hardest, as I said. And, yep, just have to see if nothing goes wrong. As it's 11 seconds gap. And I don't think in 11 seconds you can run a gap close. So. That's obviously you can't run a gap close in 10 seconds. That's ridiculous. That's unless you must make a mistake or get without fuel or without tires, and that might also be a problem. However, P1 for Peter Brojack, and he will be coming through the last couple of corners as we have the ability to go to the Senna and Prescott later, and he will take his victory as he comes over the line. Peter Brojack winning in Melbourne for the World Trophy race. Congratulations, as we then will have a 1-2 from Twister Racing, because Andreas Nielsen will take second. Well done, Twister Racing. We have 2 for Johan Allman on Ghost Speed Racing, and Mark Albers taking 4th for Ghost Speed as well. So 1-2 Twister, and 3 and 4 for Ghost Speed. Albers coming over in 2nd and 4th, which is also a delighted position, I'm sure. We have Maximilian Malamed in 5th, finishing for ATR Development. GS Ghost Speed Pro Engineering for World Trophy. Kainer Basel still racing, as Rob Swindles has gotten past of Bracon during that fight, as Rob Swindles is actually still fighting for Bracon. He's still trying to fight it off, and he is winning from Bracon. So Rob Swindles taking 7th after Kainer Basel, as Marius Bracon takes 8th, Benjamin Burmeister comes over the line in 9th without the wing. That's a little. I'm gonna have to see. Yeah, I'm gonna have to see if your car is in the right weight here, Brady. That's a lot of smoke as well. That's Benjamin Burmeister in 9th. Edward Kaur, 10. Sebastiano Filosa finished in 11th. Stanny van der Neet is the last finisher in 12th. We have the retirements. Sami Passari in 13th with brake failure. Tim Brook in 14th with engine failures. Nick Fisher in 15th for ATR with the engine failure. Takito Nunes for RFR on 16. Joe Nicholas 17, which is a brake failure. Marshall Thomas, brake failure. Matteo Zandona, brake failure. Moritz Kaumann, suspension. And Kunkel, suspension. And also Fadler, suspension. Kevin Clark with a DNF. And Sivokas with suspension. Denise, accident. And Mo Silvaria with a suspension failure on lap 1. Probably the suspension failures are coming after accidents, of course. So, we have Peter Brojack in 1, Nelson 2 and Almond 3. We'll have to see if we can get the Ghost Speed and those Twister Racing guys and TeamSpeak. Of course, I will have to see how that's working out. So, then, we will have to see what is able to be interviewed, if we can interview, if we have that time, of course. We'll have to see. Of course, we're going to take the camera to Peter Brojek, as he won this race. Give him the honor to giving the... As Pete Project doesn't have a microphone, that's a little sad, as we might want to hear him, and he doesn't have a microphone, so we'll just have to ask him in chat how he's been having the race. But yeah, that's a little so I'm gonna have to see. We might want to send him a microphone for his birthday, since he does like to win races, it seems. We'll have to see. Yeah. I'm getting a well done from a race director. I was also thank you. I'm going to say this is broadcast. I've been 3 years out of sim racing, from sim racing, and I've been getting into the hot seat quite late and quite unexpectedly. As I do not know what's going on in from a sim racing, and quite new again, and of course this has been sponsored by RC.net and Simrace and Thrustmaster with Simrace TV as broadcasting service. We do thank the broadcasting service pretty well for hosting our broadcasts, and we do thank Thrustmaster and RC.net for our sponsorships, which will be sponsoring prizes and all that nifty stuff. Yes, we will have to see how all that works out. So, I just have to keep talking until the server goes off. That's what I remember from a few years ago. So I'll just keep talking, as we'll have to see what's going on. We'll have to see if we have time or not first, as we will go for a little music, since you're probably tired of my voice right now. Of course, all this is sponsored by Thrustmaster, RC.net, and it's hosted by Simrace TV. I will either see you in a little bit, or I will be seeing you next race, which is in Malaysia.